Hi guys, Penny Rose Journals, how you doing? Today I just wanted to do something very relaxing. So I have pulled out my watercolours, these very cheap, nasty watercolours, kids' watercolours. I'm determined to use them all up. So, and I've also pulled out some of that paper packaging, or cardboard packaging, like food packaging and whatnot, that I managed to tear the surface off of. The shiny side. So yes, I am going to try painting that with watercolour. I don't know how that's going to work. I have never tried it before. It's quite rough and porous, so I think it will be all right, but we'll just wait and see. So watercolors aren't really my medium. I haven't played with them very much, so I'm not really sure how it's going to turn out, but we'll give it a go and see. And once they're dry, we might do a bit of stamping, and but we'll see what happens. First of all, I'm just taking all my little pieces and cutting them to sort of the size of a journal card, or that I would like as a journal card. These are just basically the sides of packages, sides of food package boxes. So now that the shiny labely sort of side is off of them, they'll be good. There's a few oddbod ones here that I'll just put aside for another use, but most of them, like I say, are just sort of rectangular bits out of the side of boxes, so I'll cut them into smaller rectangles and we'll give this whole watercolour business a bit of a go. Right, as I say, not really my medium. I'm not really sure how to do this. So I try several different ways. I start out like this, just mixing my colours in the sort of divots in the palette next to me with a lot of water, and just going onto the card essentially with a brush full of colour. I try all sorts of things. Eventually I sort of end up wetting the card down first before I start really adding the colour. I mean, the brush sometimes got some paint on it and it's not really an issue, but I decide that wetting the whole card and then starting to put colour on it actually works better for me. But yeah, it's a process. I sort of fiddle around doing this and that until I decide the way I like doing it. So I'll speed it up so you can watch me paint a few, and then we'll see how we get on once they're dry. You'll probably notice also that I'm mixing the colours with each other. I'm just using that same little palette area to sort of mute my colours down a bit. Like I say, these are kids' watercolours. They're very bright. There's, you know, even a few neons in here. I don't want anything quite that bright, so yeah, I'm using a lot of water and I'm mixing the colours most of the time in the same little spot, so that, you know, they're a mixture of colours and a little more muted than they're coming straight out of the palette.
Thank you.
Also, a lot of these might seem like odd colour combinations. I'm choosing generally about three colours. Obviously mixing some of them, but generally using about three colours on each card, and some of them might look like they're very odd choices to be putting together. They were, admittedly. I didn't really have an idea in mind of what I wanted to do, so I was just following my nose. There was no real planning, but when they dried, they all looked very nice, so it was no loss, and it was a very relaxing process. I wasn't really fussed on what the finished product was going to be quite honest. I mean, it's just rubbish in the end of the day. It's something that I would normally, I wouldn't, but normal people would throw in their recycle bin. So most of it is, boxes from dog treats. So I wasn't too worried about, oh my goodness, I might ruin them. Right, and here are the cards once they are dry. At least that first batch. I will gather these up and paint the rest that I have sitting on my desk here, and then we will get on doing something with these dry ones. Thank you. This is also when I stumble on my favoured technique at the end of the day of wetting down the cards and then putting colour on them. So, yeah, I decided that this works a lot better for me. Okay, that's all of the card painted, so I am going to pick these up now and put them aside to dry. And we can get on with the ones that are already dry and see what we can make out of those. Right, I've just chosen some floral sort of themed stamps out of my stamp sets, and I'm just going to use some black stays on ink and see what we can create.
Thank you. Okay, and here is the finished product. I did cut out quite a bit of the stamping because, you know, how much stamping can you actually watch? But I will put stills at the end so you can see all the finished cards. So yeah, I quite like them. I'm not going to do anything with the backs of them. I quite like the whole paint stained sort of look anyway, so I'm okay with them like that. And they will be something nice to have in my stash, just to pop in a journal or use as a thank you card or something. So yeah, you can always pop a little sentiment on them and go from there. So all right guys, I hope you enjoyed this. It was a very relaxing time for me. Yeah, I will definitely do it again. And the cardboard as a substrate, once it's had that shiny surface peeled off, worked very well with the watercolours. So yeah, give it a go. Anyway guys, have a lovely day. Thanks for being here and I will see you again next time. Bye.